Okay, good day everyone. We are still on differentiation, and what we are looking at today is product rule. Now, product rule is saying that if your y equals to uv, then your dy dx is going to be u dv dx plus v du dx. Now, don't let this scare you. It is very, very straightforward. That is, you pick the letter u and then differentiate v. Then pick the letter v, then differentiate u. So, if your y equals uv, therefore, your dy dx is going to be u dv dx plus v du dx. How do you apply this? Let's take an example. Example 1. Now, let's say you have y equals 4x minus 3. And then you have 8x plus 2, for example. Now, how do you know when to apply product rule? Anytime the question you are given is two brackets, or anytime you are given two functions that you can differentiate independently, staying side by side, or anytime there is a multiplicative function. But simply put, that anytime you have two brackets side by side, you know it is product rule. You know, for chain rule or function of function or composite function, I said the moment you see a bracket and a power, then you know that it is what? Function of function or composite rule. But for product rule, the moment you have two brackets side by side, you know that, oh, what I'm solving is product rule. And what is the first step? The first step is to call the first bracket u and call the second bracket v every time. So that means our u is 4x minus 3, then our v is 8x plus 2. Always call the first bracket u, then call the second one v. Now from here, now you know I have letter u and x here, so I'm going to look for du dx, du dx. Now if I differentiate 4x, it will give me 4. If I differentiate 3, it will give me 0. So leave that. Here I have letter v and x, so I'll look for dv dx. Now if I differentiate 8x, it will give me 8. If you differentiate plus 2, it will give me 0. So that's gone. So these are the four things you need to solve. So just come and apply it in this formula and then you are done. So from here now, I can now say that my dy dx is equal to u. What's my u? My u is 4x minus 3. You see that? Then dv dx, because what you want to do now is to cross multiply this times this plus this times this. So you will write this first. That's our u. Then dv dx, my dv dx is 8. Now instead of writing it at the back, you can put it at the front here, plus v. What's my v? My v is 8x plus 2. So you write that, 8x plus 2. And then du dx, our du dx is 4. Instead of writing it at the back, you can put it at the front here also. So from here now, your dy dx can now be 8 times 4x, that's 32x, minus 8 times 3, 12. 3 times 8, 24 rather, 24. Then plus 4 times 8, 32x, plus 4 times 2, 8. So our final answer, dy dx, will now be 32x plus 32x, that is 64x. Then minus 24 plus 8, that should give you minus 16. This is your final answer. You see that? Very direct and what? Straightforward. So the moment you are given a question in brackets and you have two brackets, you know it is product rule. Call the first one u, call the second one v, and then you follow this process. You can play this video again so that you can have a better understanding. But then, let me try to solve one more question. on this. Don't forget, product 3 says that once your y is equal to uv, then your dy dx is equal to u dv dx plus v du dx. Don't forget. I expect you to pause the video, write everything down before we continue. Okay, quickly, let's take another example on product rule. Now, product rule, if I have y equals 8x cubed minus 1 raised to power 2x plus 4. Differentiate. Look at this. Look at this. Differentiate. Now, how do you solve a question like this? Now, so the first thing you do, since it is two brackets, you know it's product rule. Call the first one u, call the second one v. So your u is 8x cubed minus 1. And then your v is 2x plus 4. So your u is the first bracket, your v is the second bracket. From here, what's our du dx? If you differentiate 8x cubed, 3 times 8 will give you 24. Then minus 1 from 3, you have x squared. So 3 times 8 is 24, minus 1 gives you 2. Don't forget, we have done this in our rule 2. If you have not watched the video, go and watch rule 1 and rule 2. Then minus 1. If you differentiate minus 1, it will give you 0. So leave it. Then you have letter v and x. So look for dv, dx. Now, if you differentiate 2x, it will give you 2. If you differentiate 4, it will give you 0. So, following your rule that says dy dx is equal to u dv dx plus v du dx. So, our dy dx is now going to be u. What's our u? Our u is 8x cubed minus 1. What's our dv dx? Our dv dx is 2. So that's like saying you are cross multiplying. This will multiply this. This will multiply this. Plus, then, v. What's your v? 2x plus 4. Then what's your du dx? Your du dx is 24x squared. Instead of putting it at the back, you can put it here. Plus 24x squared. You see that? So you can now open up the bracket. So therefore, from here, your dy dx is going to be 2 times 8x cubed. That will be 16x cubed. Then 2 times minus 1, that will be minus 2. Then 24x squared times 2x. 24 times 2 is 48. So I can say plus 48. Then x squared times x. X squared times x will give me x cubed. That is x in three places. Then 24x squared times 4. That will just be 24 times 4. You know, 4 times 4 is 16, 6. 2 times 4 is 8, 9. So 96 plus 96x squared. You see that? That is 24x squared times 4. So you just say 24 times 4. That will give me 96. Then the x squared, you also put it there. So tidy this up, your dy dx will now be equal to 16x cubed plus 48x cubed. So that's like saying 16 plus 48. So 48 plus 16, of course, that will be 4, that will be 6. So that will be 64x cubed. Then you have 96x squared, you write it, 96x squared. Then you have minus 2, minus 2. So you have arranged it well. So with this now, this is how to do product rule. So the next thing we are going to be looking at is the quotient rule. The quotient rule. Okay, good day everyone. Today we are looking at quotient rule. Still on differentiation. Now, what's quotient rule saying? Quotient rule is saying that if you have y equals to u over v, then your dy dx is going to be v du dx minus u dv dx all over v squared. You see that? So it's very simple. Don't let the formula scare you. Now, v du dx, that is, you write your v and then differentiate u. Then you write your u and then differentiate v and then do the v squared. Now, let's see how to apply this. Let's say, for example, I have y equals to 7x minus 5 all over 3x plus 2. Differentiate. The moment I see a question this way, I don't need to be told that it is what? I don't need to be told that it is quotient true. Once it is a fraction, you have something up, you have another one down. And so what you always do is that call what you have on top u, call the one down v. That is the rule. So your u is 7x minus 5, and your v is 3x plus 2. Call the up u, call the down v. So here I have letter u and x, so I look for du dx. What's du dx? Differentiate 7x, 7. Differentiate 5, 0. Then you have v and x, so you look for dv, dx. Differentiate 3x, that will give you 3. Differentiate 2, that will give you 0. So these are the four things that you need. Just come and substitute them here, and then you have solved this question. So from here, I can say my dy dx is equal to v. From here now, what's my v? My v is 3x plus 2. Du dx. What's my du dx? 7. So I told you, you can put it here. Even though the formula is at the back, but you can put it here. So it's like you are also cross multiplying. Minus u. What's our u? Our u is 7x minus 5. So I can put it here and say 7x minus 5. Then dv dx. What's our dv dx? 3. Over v squared. What's our v? 3x plus 2 squared. You see that? So we are following this formula. You write your v first. Your v is 3x plus 2. You put it. Du dx. Our du dx is 7. Instead of putting it at the back like the formula, I can also put it at the front. Why? 2 times 3 is the same thing as 3 times 2. Commutative law. Okay? Then, minus. I put the minus. U. What's our u? Our u is 7x minus 5. Then dv dx. Our dv dx is 3. Instead of putting it at the back, I put it at the front. Over v squared. What's our v? 3x plus 2. So I just put it square. You see that? Now, I expect you to pause the video and then copy this, because I'm going to clean it. Then after you have done this, the next thing you are going to do is to now say that expand the bracket. So your dy dx is going to be 7 times 3, that's 21x, plus 7 times 2, that's 14. Then minus, you still open the bracket, 3 times 7x, or you can leave it, minus 3 times 7x is minus 21x. Then minus 3 times minus 5 is plus 15. Everything over 3x plus 2. All what? All squared. So eventually, your final answer is now going to be dy dx equals 21x minus 21x, you know it will cancel out. 14 plus 15, that's 29, all over 3x plus 2 squared. That's the final answer. You see that? So this is quotient true. So I'm going to be giving you a lot of questions that you're expected to practice. Get back to me on the number on the screen. If you have not subscribed, click on subscribe and the bell button so that when I drop the next video, you can watch. Thank you.